We are beginning tonight with new information on the controversy surrounding Salinas Valley Memorial Hospital and allegations of financial mismanagement by the hospital's board. Last night, Action News first broke the story of this letter, a request from Central Coast Assemblyman Luis Alejo for a state audit of hospital finances. But Alejo refused comment on where he got all of his information. That is until now. Today, he is talking to us, and Action News reporter May Chow is live in Salinas with more.
Well, Aaron, Alejo's letter comes in the wake of contentious labor negotiations at the hospital, as well as a retirement package for CEO Sam Downing, which the union and others say is very excessive. Now, Alejo's letter and his call for an audit clearly shares those same thoughts, but the information he uses to support his points vary greatly from what hospital management says is the truth.
If there's nothing to hide, then the Salinas Valley Memorial should be open to having our state auditor go in there and review and see what is happening.
Assemblyman Luis Alejo is turning up the heat on SVMH. His letter contains allegations of mismanagement, backroom deals, and possible illegal financial dealing.
I look forward to seeing the hospital officials and their high-priced lawyer come to Sacramento next week and explain to the legislature how they thought it was okay to approve an $800,000 salary and a $4 million pension and a $150,000 pension every year after that at the expense of patient care.
But Alejo refuses to say where he gets his information.
I'm not going to mention any names, but there are numerous local residents.
How come you won't mention any names?
Well, because to protect their identities.
We took a look at the numbers side by side, what Alejo says versus what the hospital management says. Alejo's letter contends Downing made over $790,000, while the hospital's public records say it was just over $668,000. Alejo also contends that Rabobank President Harry Wardwell's position on the SVMH board has led to sweetheart deals for the bank.
One of their board members, Harry Wardwell, calls me the next day. He's very upset. And then he ends up hanging up the phone on me. And if the board has nothing to hide, they should be welcoming this audit with open arms.
And I just ask him why he would write these things about our hospital and our board without calling any of us. He didn't want to listen.
Alejo tells Action News he did not call the hospital prior to his letter, and when we asked him about it, he says a public hearing will answer all of the questions. Meantime, an SVMH spokesperson says the hospital has not hired a special attorney to handle this matter. Now, Assemblyman Luis Alejo also wrote in his letter that inside of SVMH, there are multiple Rabobank ATMs. However, when we went to the hospital, we were only able to find one. Aaron.
All right, May, thank you. The Joint Legislative Audit Committee will hold an open hearing next Wednesday to decide whether or not to go forward with this audit. SVMH has not said whether or not it will be attending that hearing. If you'd like to read the Assemblyman's entire letter requesting the state audit along with the hospital's response, it is on the As Seen On section of our website, ksbw.com.